عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It gives me the pleasure to be with you here, and I'm very happy to share with you a little knowledge and thinking and thought about the Sudan. Actually, we have to plan very well. One of the big problems facing Sudan and facing most of the country who fail to develop is institutional failure. We have a very serious institutional failure contributed to the failure of Sudanese state and other countries who have used resources they don't develop. And actually, I'm here to bring you all together. We need a plan for every sector to come together. We plan to the Sudan. And we put our experience of a country similar to Sudan, like Malaysia, to come with plan, strategies, master plan. So this is one of the plans. Since we are in the digital revolution, we should talk about digital economy, and then we have to talk about knowledge-based economy. We want to talk about the flagships institutions, actually. Electronic government, electronic health, technopreneurship, whatever the sectors that we have to have a flagship. The pillars are the elements, human capital, information and communication technology, whatever the factors of production. So this mainly the content of the presentation. So this is the history of development of human economy from the primitive to agriculture, to industrial, to information, to knowledge-based economy. And the center of this revolution is the knowledge development. Knowledge is very important. Knowledge will create wealth. And we can see the countries have no resources like Japan, Singapore, whatever. They are having very high standard of living. The countries' resources like mine and other countries, they are hardly to survive. So what is the difference? The difference is using knowledge to create value in economic activities. And this is all about knowledge economy, using knowledge to create value or wealth. And the wealthy people in the world who are investing in knowledge, from Bill Gates to everybody, these are the richest people in the world. They are investing in knowledge. And in this year, Nobel Prize in economic science has been awarded to two professors. One is introducing new factors of production based on knowledge, and one is including the environmental factors. Digital technology is very important now, and the economy is digital economy, and we have the digital revolution we have to follow. We have digital dividends and digital divide. The digital divide is the usage of information and communication technology is the difference. For example, there is a digital divide between UK and Sudan. The penetration and access to digital technology is higher. But the digital dividend is the benefit from using the technology in production. Although the digital devices are available everywhere, but the benefit of using this, the digital dividend, is very low in most of the countries. Is productivity actually makes a difference? Productivity is very important, actually, for any nation. And especially the quality of the factors of production, which will create the technological progress that we call it total factor productivity. And this is the difference between we have a developed and developing countries. Although East Asian countries, they work very hard, only two countries or three countries classified as productivity-driven countries, such as Japan, Korea, and China. Still, Malaysia, with all this beautiful development, is input-driven. They are not able to create value from technology and human capital to have a technological progress or productivity-driven. So this is very important, actually, for Sudan. Malaysia plan by next year should be a developed nation, but unfortunately, it cannot be achieved because the one factor is human capital development. They fail to follow their East Asian counterparts to change the mentality of the Malaysian people to be skillful and create value. This is a big challenge facing Malaysia to achieve this vision, although they have a very good plan. So the human capital, the human development is very important. So if we want to develop Sudan, we have to come with the policies how we can bring Sudanese skills together to develop the Sudan. So Malaysia is not able to achieve this vision. The main factor is human capital, and then they are not able to create their indigenous technology. So we have to learn social capital. That actually I was discussing with you. Social capital actually is networking and benefit from the community. In terms of social aspects, Sudanese are very socially connected. But unfortunately, in terms of business and economic, Sudanese are not connected socially to benefit from each other. So that's what I call it. They have the mentality of exclusion. They are very reluctant to share the knowledge. They are very reluctant to share the political power. They are very reluctant to change everything. But when it comes to the social activities, they are very keen. But this is not create value for economics. So we need to look for this seriously. Intellectual capital is very important, which is the human mind and skills created. One of the most important pillars. Sudan actually has very good resources, and most of the people are youth. Allah gives us everything, but unfortunately, we don't use it to benefit, and we are facing a lot of challenges. So you need to use this, utilize these resources through good planning and enhancing all the economic pillars and building the flagships for the Sudan and plan well to move forward. And it's going to be if we come together. Sudanese knowledge economy pillars. Actually, the most important institutions with the flagships, I will discuss later on. We will take the experience of the countries who develop their flagships. Then to have a flagships, you have to have institution. In Malaysia, they call it Multimedia Super Corridor. When Malaysia planned in 1996, they came with the idea of Multimedia Super Corridor, which is the area from Kuala Lumpur Twin Tower, they call it KLCC, to the airport. This whole area developed as interior area. It was planned in 1996. And one of the institutions related to this is our university. Actually, the official name is Telecom University. But it's a part of this Multimedia Super Corridor. They call it, change the name to Multimedia University. So they come with master plan. We have to come with the knowledge economy master plan to develop the flagships. In Sudan, I think we have one of the city. They call it African Technology City, but unfortunately, it's not functioning very well. We can take it, and then we can see how to improve it in the future to have an institution like Multimedia Super Corridor to plan how to develop the intelligent area to create value from our economic activity. This can be used for every aspect. When we come to the flagship, we will see how it's important to have the knowledge economy and the flagships for the knowledge economy. Okay? These are the flagships in Malaysia, actually from electronic government to in education, it can be also, we have electronic education, health can be, identity card can also use. In business, we call it technopreneurship. Smart schools, smart universities. Actually, our university was the first digital university established in 1996. Then education can be included, then for health, for tourism, all the institutions of the government, actually all the sectors can be developed. Education is very important as the first speaker talk. And we are qualified to be a center of education, actually. I'm very happy that we have many universities in Sudan, although they have no quality. It has no quality. The number of PhDs and masters produced stands are very huge. So only we need how to plan to accredit the university first, we have to come with the accreditation. Because one of the speakers before he talked about the ranking of Sudanese university. If you have no accreditation, you cannot be ranked. So the first step, you have to accredit the university, and you have to come with an agency. In Malaysia, we have a Malaysian qualification agency. These will approve everything, even the acceptance of the students should be approved from them. So we have to come with the accreditation body, Sudanese accreditation agency. Then we have to improve the education. Then I guarantee for you, we will be the center of education in Africa and Middle East. And this will create more money, because the money came from knowledge economy, from the service. And will create tourism value, because if you have foreign students, their families will visit them, this experience of Malaysia. And we can develop our historical sites. We have good knowledge economy base for the tourism. We have to introduce ourselves to the world, actually. Okay? Technicians are very important. It's not only the university degree or PhD or master's. China succeed because they have many technicians. Even the iPhone is produced in China. So we need to give focus. We have a lot of people who leave the school. There are many people who are not complete their studies. We can train them and we can make them technicians. We have the very good experience of Kenana Sugar Company. It came in 1980s and trained many Sudanese. Even those who lost the school, they go and work as a labor, then they go for the training center, and then they get the certificate, then they have. So we need more technician besides other things. Collaboration between the universities and the economic sectors are very important. We have to create a culture of collaboration between the private sector and public sector, between the university in Sudan and other universities, between the companies and the university. Academic excellence is very important. If we go through the education, accreditation, then we soon, with few years, we can see we will be proud that many Sudanese university rank. Foreign direct investment, in order to attract the foreign direct investment that develop Malaysia and most of each Asian countries, you have to plan very well. You have to have a plan, you have to have strategies, you have to have everything available online. And people will, and the companies will come to Sudan. Definitely, we have to create economic, political stability first, and then everything will come in order. So the new Sudan, to me, all the Sudanese must come together. They put their hand, their heart and minds, put their skills together. Then we have to create a conducive environment for investment. We are Sudanese. We are not able to invest in our country. How we can attract foreign companies if we don't create conducive environment? These also need plan, and we're getting the experience of the people. The second pillar is information and communication technology is very important. However, technology is only facilitator. People will make the change. People will make the change. We have to train the people, and we have to create the human capital. Then we can develop the digital technology applications. We have a good experience of mobile phone or mobile banking. We have, for example, we have 8 million in Sudan who are in need for microfinance. I come with my student who are retiree from the Center of Bank of Sudan. We come with the idea of mobile microfinance. So the outreach now is only 1 million. It means that 10% of need of finance, they have the chance. So if we create the idea of use the digital technology in view of knowledge economy, you can cover the 8 million through mobile microfinance, the traditional mobile, and then we can increase the outreach and financial inclusion. So this is one application of the knowledge economy. This is just for example. Entrepreneurship is very important. We have to have new business model. The way that we think, we cannot do business. We have to get many people to be trained how to do business, and then we have to come with a new business model. There are a lot of problems of issues of getting the money, but however, the state, if it's stable, will support the venture capital to establish the business. But you have to come with a new business model. Yeah. There are many barriers and problems, but the banking sector is qualified to be connected with mobile banking or internet banking, then we can have more financial inclusion. Human capital development is very important, and this is one of the problems that contribute to the failure of Malaysia. We need to create also high-skilled labor force, especially the technician. We can follow China in this. Training of graduated students. We have huge millions or thousands of students who are graduated for many years. They have no job. We have to create a graduate training fund to train the student for soft skills, for language, computer skills, whatever. And by the way, I'm the one who created the, and one of the people who was in Cairo, we created the fund for student support. Sanduq Tamwil al-Talib. I'm the one who makes the first notice. So we can have the same one for training. We train them, then we give them the hope. They want to do business, we show them how to do business. They want to work, we show how them to do. So new business model is very important. There are many type of business. The time is very short, but we can follow this. Brain drain, this is a very serious problem. Most of the Sudanese are working outside. To attract them, we have to create conducive environment and plan very well. Automatically, we can have brain gain. Seriously, I'm one of the who hoping to go back to Sudan at any time. We miss many things. We achieve many things and we miss many things. So the brain drain will can be changed to brain gain, attracting the Sudanese talent around the globe. We should have also long-term strategy for developing the flagships and pillars of knowledge economy. Recognition is very important for individuals, for the companies, will encourage the business, encourage people to contribute. Okay, that's what I have talked before. Sudan can be a center of education if you accredit our university. Unfortunately, we don't have classified small and medium enterprises company. 90% of the world companies in every country are small and medium enterprises. We have to classify the companies and we have to have master plan for small and medium enterprises, and then we allow people to do the business so we can make the difference. These are flagships. Actually, you can plan how to develop the flagships from electronic government to all the sectors. I'm working, this work actually in progress. We can benefit from everybody to contribute. We need also to develop the cyber laws because there are many cyber crimes. The traditional laws cannot solve the problem. We need to talk also about the issues of intellectual property to protect the invention and innovation of new business model, new ideas, new technology. We have to come with a Sudan Knowledge Economy Master Plan blueprint, accommodating all the issues. I'm ready to contribute in this and to manage and to coordinate everybody in his area. We can share together. This is very important, actually. If you don't plan well, we cannot succeed. So we should come with a Sudan Knowledge Economy Master Plan. The time is very little. These are the main issues of the flagships. The award is very important, and the most important is inclusion. We have a very serious problem of inclusion in Sudan, not only financial inclusion, political inclusion, education inclusion, research inclusion. And I give you the experience of Malaysia. This is the Malaysian Senate of our university. I get the pleasure to serve for the last 5 years until now. And they don't put me as, because I am Sudanese or Malaysian, that is guidelines. Whoever is a professor or associate professor will be elected to be as a member. And they will get the best of your knowledge. So you see the inclusion. In Arab countries, I don't want to name, they don't even include the foreigners in the faculty board. You see how Malaysians they think. They misuse me for 5 years, and they put me in 5 committees. I have very hard time for meetings and many things, but I'm very happy because I have been included, not excluded. So let us to come together and solve the problem of mentality of exclusion in Sudan that backwarded us. Thank you very much.
My question and comment to Professor Sadiq, really his presentation was inspiring in comparing Sudan to Malaysia. And we hope that Sudan will be able to catch up after this uprising and what's going on. I think one of the main problems we had is that visionary leadership. All of us, we are still talking about constitution, and no, very few development is going on. And now we have a visionary leadership, youth leadership, and they're looking forward for a good in Sudan. Because in many parts of the world, I meet people and they ask me, you have good people, you have good experts, but your country is very poor, it's not developing. So what's your advice for Sudanese to come up with this?
Okay, please close the mic. Okay, thank you very much indeed. Actually, one of the most important elements of development or economic growth of every country is the leadership. However, good governance, leadership, rule of law, then second to that, education service, health service, research and development, and then lastly, saving and investment. So leadership is very important, and this is one of the big problems that we are facing. We don't have well-defined leader to follow. We don't have, this is what I call it, a mentality of exclusion. People, they disagree in everything. We are here now, we are talk, when we come to the politics, then everybody will disagree. Something other than leadership and politics, we can sit together for long time. But in a few seconds when you come about leadership, and I have observed this when we Sudan government, the falling government, want to form the Council of Sudanese Experts and Scientists. We have been there for 3 days. When they come to make a body, then everybody against everybody. I was sitting behind just and I'm watching. So it is a very serious problem. Leadership is a very serious problem in Sudan and in Africa. And this is exactly what we need to solve. One of the examples now, we are not able to form any government until now. We don't have well-defined leader. And unfortunately, this is a very serious problem since the independence of Sudan. And if you have a good leader, then we should go to other elements. We need good governance, we need rule of law, we need other things. We have to build all the sectors of the economy. So I agree with you, we have a very serious leadership problem.
Can I comment on that? I disagree. So I don't think the issue is a leadership issue. I think the issue is the conflict of interest and the hidden agendas of the group. So one of the basics of creating a team, even if you create a team of 5 people, is to share your vision, agree on it, and be working for the cause, the common cause, regardless of your personal interests. So it's very easy to say that because I do it in my work. We work in a team, and sometimes some of the things that I do for the team are conflicting with my personal interest. I stay late and, you know, I get stressed by taking 5 projects at a time, all that stuff. So it's an education issue. So you to participate in a team, you need to know how leadership works, and to be a leader, you need to know the how to unite people around something, how to bring their own passion and knowledge and skills for the common goal. So I disagree that and to the generalization that we have a leadership issue. I see a lot of Sudanese leaders in my work in Sudan. I work with a lot of leaders, Sudanese leaders in research in Sudan from the UK here. And Even when I was back, I worked with people in Zain. We have truly amazing leaders. It's what we see is the contribution of them is not big enough to show that we have good leaders, because they are just scattered around, and they don't have a systematic institutions where their efforts and outputs are magnified in a way to show that we have leadership as a nation. So I think we just need to go back to the basics and really work as a team, even if it's a small team like this organization here. This is an example of true leadership, isn't it? So we have different people contributing. We have a vision here we agree on, even if you haven't seen it. You agree to the vision of WASD, which is coming here and contribute to the sustainable development of, and discussing those topics. So I just wanted to say that.
Thank you.
بنحلم بفضاء أوسع، بنحلم بزمن أجمل، بلاد ميلاد، بلاد ميلاد.